Hello guys, my name is Fazalam and welcome back to another video tutorial on Blender. So today I'm gonna show you how to bake normal maps from a high detailed model and apply them to a low poly model. Here you can see this is my high detailed model. This is a dice type of thing that I made. So this is just because to show you how normal map works. So in here you can see how many subdivisions I have used. This is just because to show you that this all the details that you can make in a high poly model, and you can actually apply those details into a very very low poly model, as you can see in here, which have only 6 faces, and in here and in this high poly model in here, how many are there? 48,256 faces. This is really a very good optimization tip, as you know that in most game engines, most game developers use this normal maps to optimize their game. They want to show this high quality detail, but they also want the geometry to be as low as it can be. So now today we're gonna talk about this. Alright, so let's get started. So first in here, first thing you need to remember is that they both are overlapping each other completely. As you can see in here, they both are overlapping each other. They are on top of each other. So, and also their pivot point must be in the same, so so that they can be matched in the same point. Okay, so now the second thing is that you need to unwrap this low poly model, because you are going to bake a low poly model using its UVs, using your low poly mesh UVs. Alright, so let's open up our UV image editor by sliding this window and selecting UV image editor, and now tab into edit mode and then press U to unwrap. Select smart UV project and press OK. Now you can see here our UVs are unwrapped. Now tab back to the object mode and then select your model. Actually, first you need to create an image. Now in here, select new image. Now let's name it. I'm gonna name it normal 1. That's it. And then I'm gonna multiply the resolution by 2, and in here also 2. Now uncheck this alpha and press OK. Now our image is created. Make sure to save this image. Save this as image. I am storing all of my tutorials data into a single folder. So tutorials. I'm gonna make another folder named normal map tutorial. Okay. Now normal map 1.png. Hit save as image, and now your image has been saved. Now select your low poly mesh and go to your materials tab and click add new material. Before adding new material, make sure you are in cycles render mode. Alright, now you click the plus material button, and now let's rename this cube1_mat. Now open up the node editor. Alright, press N to hide this bar. Now press Shift A and add texture, image texture, place it right here and select our normal one image. Now while this is selected, go to the renders tab and in here bake settings, select this to normal, checkbox this selected to active checkbox right here. And now first select your high poly mesh and then select your low poly mesh. Alright, now if you click this bake button, your normal map should start baking. Let's open our UV image editor by sliding this window over here and selecting UV image editor. This is our normal map, and when it start baking you'll see some changes in this window. Now if I hit this bake button, see it's converted to blue. Another process is started in here, texture bake, you can see. Now you have to wait according to your image resolution and detail of the mesh. Now in here, let me show you by pressing shift space. When you press shift space while cursor in your window, you can actually maximize that window. And if you press shift space again, you can exit that window. See, if I press shift space here while having my cursor in this window, you can see I have opened this node editor window to the full screen, like in here, like in here, like in here. Okay, now let's see in here our normal map. You can see these parts are looking good, but not these parts. These are greenish, I don't know. So if you are getting these type of colors, means something is wrong with this image. As you can see here, all the parts but these circles are out of our low poly box. So in order to fix that, you can scale up your model, or you can increase the ray distance. So this is a bit tricky. You need to find a sweet spot of your raycast distance. If your mesh is my mesh is just a cube, but if your mesh is a little bit complicated, means if your mesh has a hole between it or your mesh is curved, make sure the outer part when you do not increase your ray, so that it hits the other part of the mesh, or you will get some weird artifacts. Alright, while this said, let's start baking it all over again. Select your low poly mesh first and then select your high poly mesh first and then select your low poly while holding shift. And now let's click bake. Now let's see if this fixed our issue or not. Alright, yeah, this fixed our issue. Now all of our normal map, all of our faces of this normal map is baked perfectly. Now I'm gonna save this blend file and I'm going to show you inside Eevee how this normal map is actually working. So if I press Ctrl S, I can actually save our blend file. Let's say normal example dot blend, hit enter, and now make sure you save the image before exiting. Save image, and now press Ctrl S again. Okay, now I'm gonna close this one. Now I'm going to select my 2.80. This is Eevee. Now I'm gonna go to file and then open, and now this normal example rent file. Let's open it up. Alright, so we are inside this EV. So okay, now we have our high poly mesh and low poly mesh beneath it, so we need to separate them because of the EV don't have layers in it. So before opening EV, we need to do some adjustment to our blend file. Let's open this our old blender version again and open our normal map example. Alright, now in here first thing we need to do is select this our high poly mesh and okay, so modifier is actually applied. You don't need to worry. If you are having this you have this high poly mesh and you don't have subdivision surface modifier applied, make sure you have applied to it. Okay, now after this you need to make sure that these positions of your boxes are now different. So let's grab this by pressing G and Y to move this along the Y axis in here, and in here let's grab this and again Y and move this here. Alright, let's move this a bit, move them a bit closer. Alright, now we're good to go. Press Control S. In here, Blender 2.8, the EV version, normal map example. Alright, now we are inside the Blender 2.8. Now I'm going to Cycles render mode. No, not Cycles, EV render mode. Alright, now in here, let's add an HDR image. Background, let's select all right in color, it's here, I guess. Yes, image text, not environment texture. Alright, now let's select a HDRI. Well, I am going to use Blender Guru Starter Pack Architecture Academy HDRI from Blender Guru. You can use anyone. And at this point, I'm just opening this up for display purpose, how this normal map looks like. In real life, you will be performing this inside your game engine or in Eevee, I don't know, but I'm just doing this just to show you how normal maps works. Okay, so first let's edit material of our cube. In here, let's remove diffuse map and let's add shader metallic. Okay, now I'm using normal map. Now add a normal map shader in vector normal map and add it to the normal, and add the color output with color input of the normal, and let's see. Alright, now you can see how our cube is looking here. It has the same detail as this one have. You can see depth and height of this cube is actually showing up in here. You can see it's more glossy than this. You can always mess around with the material. You can increase the roughness in order to match this one, but so far so good. Our normal map is working perfectly fine. So yeah, this is it for now. Thanks for watching, guys, and hopefully I'll see you next time.